And we end up now in Ireland, and we see the same beautiful kids who just delighted us with their performance. Shannon McKinney, she's wearing a traditional Irish dance costume featuring embroidered ancient Celtic designs, a hand-crocheted Irish lace collar, and the stylized shawl on the back. And joining her is Colin Bonfield. Colin is wearing a traditional Irish lip sweater from the Erin Island region in west of Ireland. The unique patterns stitched into the winter sweaters by the women in the family help to identify the fishermen in case of an accident. The sweaters are made from the wool of the family's sheep herd, and his waist is a hand-woven belt, and he's wearing a traditional Irish cap. And Colin, you can, when you are off the stage, leave the sweater for me, please. Thank you.
I mentioned that we have some special guests tonight. So from Jordan, we have a guest who is visiting Cleveland. So he's just a visitor here, but he agreed to show up on stage. Come on, come on the stage.
He's so really up to
Nasser Al-Khuz. He is wearing a traditional garment of Jordan, which is very unique, as a traditional clothing format consists of tunic, shirts, trousers, and an elaborate over garment with a belt. They also cover their head with a typical Arabian scarf, which is like a turban. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Okay, now he likes it so much, he doesn't want to leave. Well, you can stay here as long as you want. And coming up on the stage, our friends from Korea, look at them. We have Hancock, he's wearing his traditional costume, and we'll be presented by Julian Cho Harris and Park Hae Lee, Yoon-ah Lee, 7 years old, and Yoon-ah Lee, 3 years old. And clothing is unique. Historically, the Korean people were both politicians and aristocrats were also wearing different clothes depending on formality and fashion. It's affected by introducing a foreign civilization. The majority of the common people have enjoyed wearing white clothes. The basic configuration of skirt and blouse and pants is fair. If you wear on the body itself, it also appears straight look and the aesthetic features to help revive the curve. It's also because the structure does not have pockets. Unlike in many countries, handball costume, a jacket and skirt, it separates the upper and the upper there are divided over the form. Thank you.
Now we continue our journey to Lebanon. We have Mrs. Eva Budiak wearing a very unique costume dating in the 18th century, and it was typical for mountain Lebanon. The lady's head is called tantour, and it was covered with natural silk that was the main local industry at that time. Her husband, Issam Budiak, is presenting the men's outfit. The man wore a man on the head, and some of them wore tarbush, as you can see on our next model, Nemer Swedi. So he's dressed in traditional costume of Lebanon, and his daughter, Miss Elena. This costume is typical public costume outfit for the Lebanon.
Well, next time we will have these people back on the stage to dance. You have to watch them dancing. They're phenomenal, absolutely. Okay, now we go to Africa from Liberia. We have Samapio and Martin Zanbe. Martin, incidentally, is the president of the Liberian organization in Cleveland. And they are wearing traditional gown of Liberian West African culture, worn on formal occasion. They are hand sewn. And folks, friends, if we can just take a moment and share our thoughts with these great folks from Liberia. They have been going through some really difficult times. Let's offer our good wishes to them. They all are families back in Liberia.
Mexico. Norma Sabat is wearing Chiapas regional dress. The Chiapas typical dress is truly unique work of art, very different from the dresses in other parts of Mexico. It is made by hand by local women, originally from the town of Chiapa de Corzo. It consists of a white skirt with a full decoration of stripes, full with colorful and stunning flowers, usually embroidered in silk or similar thread. Some people say that flowers represent the region diversity. Modesto Garcia, wearing an outfit from the tropical Mexican area of Veracruz. This is the typical dance garment, white, wearing a pair of pants and shirt with a red sash and strong hat for hard sole shoes.
All the way from Nepal now we have Tika Acharya and Narayan Pradhan. They are wearing Nepali traditional attires, Boto, Dwara Saruwai and Dhaka Topi cap for men, and Sari and Chobani and Cholo and Gunya for women. Women wear these silky clothes that befit their body in a silky manner. The Nepali attire are intertwined with the culture and space, and all Nepali people feel dignified in spreading its identity. The crest of this cap, the topi, is shaped resembling Mount Everest. I'm sure you can make that out, and symbolizes the great Himalayas. This Bhaguni cap and Dhaka topi are spangled with various decorations whose importance is known throughout the world.
Now I want you to welcome Amelia Kotlarsic.
Yeah, we're okay.
She is wearing a flowered skirt with white apron, decorative bedding vest, white blouse, and flowered ratted with ribbons on the head. Gustav Kotlarsic is wearing white and red stripes pants, white shirt with red ribbon, tie, and navy blue vest, large belt and bell rings. On his head will be a square head with a peacock feather.
Okay, who's coming up next? Okay, all right. Now, this is interesting. We have Laura Golson wearing an authentic Russian boy costume. Ukrainian and Russian boys are usually very simple to talk tonight. Their dress indicates their importance in the country and in government circles. Oh boy, these are important people here. And who is joining her? Oh my God! Good Lord! Is this our Kenneth J. Kovac, our own president of the board? Oh my God! Oh my! He's here wearing the uniform of a Don Cossack, a Cossack from the Don River region of Russia. Ken is an honorary Don Cossack of Volgograd, Cleveland's Russian sister city.
So now I'm going to